Scene of Advent of Code. Let's see whether Eric has stepped up the difficulty or not. So I'm going to go ahead and start reading the question, and also I'll pop up my laptop so I can go ahead and read Twitch chat. So what have we here?
Is anyone already working?
We have produce running around. Okay. And we have a kitchen. The quality. Oh god, are we machine learning hot chocolate recipes? Similar to how you can machine learn chocolate chip cookie recipes? Great. Okay. Two recipes on the board. Each elf has a current recipe. They combine their recipes. Oh, this is genetic programming. Right. Okay. Right. Not even genetic programming, this is like manipulating digits and playing with around with the representations in base 10 of things. Great. Okay, cool. That seems useful. one plus the score. Oh, we're gonna need the ring buffer again. Yep, we need the ring buffer. Great. What is the score of the 10 recipes immediately after? Oh, great. Okay. This requires no input file. That's easy enough. Keyboard off by one. Okay. No need for that. No need for that. No need for that. Okay, so we always start with 3 and 7, I think. Yeah, okay, great. So we're going to start by how many recipes have we done? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So I'll say 16 by default. Going to need the ring class. So similar to the previous day in which we used a ring, we're going to need to start by defining the ring as 3 and 7, and we're going to need to maintain pointers to the rings. So I'm going to look at the ring class documentation, which will give me an idea as to how I'm getting started here. So we want package container ring, and we're going to need to define first ring new with two elements. And then the ring's value, first value is going to be 3. And then the value of the next one is going to be 7. Okay. Something like that should do the trick. So now I've got Elf 1 and Elf 2 that are each working through the recipes. Okay. Happen to look around in general, they move to different recipes. What happens if they land on the same recipe? I guess 1 plus the score of their current recipe. Okay. I need to keep track of the number of items in the ring because those rings don't keep track of how many elements are in them. And we need to be able to do modular arithmetic to avoid a bunch of pointless circling around in the ring. Although in practice, the number of moves is going to be at most 10. So I think that's going to be fine. But still, I'd like to aim for efficiency rather than not. The recipe starts off as 2. So we're going to combine the recipes is less than or equal to N. Okay. Less than I is 0, I is less than 10, I plus plus. Going to take recipes after that. After the first 9 on the scoreboard, why do we say the first 9? How do I identify what the next 10 recipes are? That's not what I don't understand. Oh, right, because we have the recipe we did the 1, we did the 4, and that will cause us add 5. They're added to the end of the scoreboard in the order in which they were created. 3, 7, 1, 0. 1, 0 goes to 1, 0 again, appended to the end. Okay, so we're always appending to the end. I don't understand. After the first 9 on the... Oh, got it. So I need to keep track of... Yep. That's fine. So we just need to record the nth recipe. We need to record what the last recipe is in the chain as well. So that's fine. Sorry, that took me a second. So we always keep track of the start of the ring, and we keep track of the number of recipes. That way, once we know, so here we do the addition of recipes to the end. But over here, we need to first start by rewind to the recipe, then read forward by 10. Okay, so I is then, right, we could potentially overshoot the total number of recipes and have to go backwards that many. Right. So we need to compute n could be higher than the number. And then, let's see, so if I'm trying to get to the fourth entry and I've got to the fourth recipe, and I know that my ring has six elements, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, yep, then I would need to go backwards by 1, 2, 3. Okay. Okay, now. Don't save it under a different name. Okay. That should do it. Okay, so now let's do the inner loop. This works is, let me just make sure that there's no questions in Twitch chat. Keeping laptops awake is a giant pain. You don't want spoilers. Yeah, go watch the recording. I don't know why I have the editor window so small. I like 80 columns mainly. Okay. So. So we need to, sum is going to be the sum of these things. Actually, I just want to not do less type mangling. Okay. Now, the sum can be at most two digits because we're just adding individual digits together. So what I want is sum 1 is going to be sum divided by 10, 2 is going to be sum percent 10. What happens if the score winds up being exactly 0? Is there a scenario in which the sum is exactly 0 if I have 2 zeros in a row? Can I get 2 zeros in a row? No, I cannot get 2 zeros in a row, possibly, I think. Because if that were to happen, you know, I could potentially get 10 as a value. But after I get 10 as a value, it becomes the case that I could potentially have 2 zeros. I think 0 is fine, so that's fine. Okay. If sum 1 is not equal to 0, then we append that to the end. So e start n plus plus. Start prove. Now I need to look at the linking a new ring in such that r next becomes s and returns the original value to r next. Okay. So yep. That should work. Then we are going to create a new ring with one element. Okay, that's fine. The elements of S inserted after R, the result points to the element following the last. Okay, that's okay because I'm just keeping track of that. That's okay. Okay. And finally. Okay. So let's try this. Okay, E2. Clearly cannot be correct. Why is that not correct? Start out with three. Oh, because we're never advancing. Right. We have to always. Now we have to advance. Okay. So now 1 plus the square of your current recipe. Should work. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, that's clearly not right. Why is that not correct? Let's just double check this. Okay, let's see whether that looks correct. Okay, adding 10, adding 10, adding 01, adding 02, adding 04, adding 05, adding 01, 05, 08, 09, adding 16, 7, 7, 9, 2. Okay. Oh. Right. Oops. I think that should do it. Let's see that. 4. 5, 5, 7, 7. But we need to get the ones after that number. So if I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 recipes, then I need to okay. So does that work? Okay. So now I can just run this with that value. Oops. I definitely don't want to be printing as I go. Just make sure this runs fast. Yep, that makes sense. Correct. Rank 564. Excellent. Okay. So these are in the square to the left of the first recipes. Okay. Great. All right. So part B. Okay. So if part B is true, then we're just going to always continue. Let's see. Okay. Decompose that into digits. So we're going to okay. Okay. So if part B, or even if not part B, this is not equal to zero. Working percent 10. Append. Now, at each step here, I'm going to remember the most recent digits that we've seen. Now, okay, right. Okay. see and check. Expected. Let's see. It's being returned. It's being returned is the original value for art next. Cool, it's fine. Five, blah, 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 occurs after 9 recipes. What's the end there? Okay, we'll check this. That's fine. Print line. Should work. Let's make sure that still works. Oops, that needs to be a ring pointer. Oh, okay, I've got my argument order wrong. Oh, I see. Right. That's why we did it that way. Because we need the value outside of the loop. Fair enough. Okay. Okay. Let's just double check this number 51589. Oh, it's, 107, that's correct. With part B. We should find a match at 9 recipes, not 738 recipes. So why did that not work? Let's just look at some of these other ones to figure out why I'm systematically off. 559414 appears at, yeah, okay, that's way too many recipes. Okay. Getting pretty close, I think. Getting pretty close. Just have to debug this. Now let's make sure that this is clean. Oops. I forgot what that caused. So that still works correctly. That looks correct. Okay. Oh, I have a suspicion. Let's make sure that I'm parsing this correctly. So, is that correct? Five, one, five, eight, nine. Oh, it's already reversed. Ah, that would do it. Okay. So actually that's fine. For I is 0, I is less than length of 10, plus. Find a match after 14 recipes, but we need to subtract the length of the pattern from it. Okay. Okay, find a match at 9 recipes. Let's check some of these other test cases. 59414 finds a match at 2018 recipes. That looks okay. All right, let's give my input a shot, which is 293801. All right, let's try that. Correct, rank 384. Okay, that was super fast. Sorry, Blar Girl. The show's over. This was a unusually short puzzle, I would say, or at least it's short if you have a ring. So I'm going to remove that print statement that I added here. What I'm going to do with the extra time, I think, since I usually budget these puzzles to take about an hour, is I'm going to go through and comment my code now with the verbal commentary that I finish from out loud. I'm going to write that down so that people who are reading this my code after the fact can actually understand it rather than having to leaf through a long video. The digits in reverse from least to greatest. Elven numbers, first and second. Okay. Okay, that looks good. Let's make sure that still runs. Yep, that looks okay. And let's make sure that looks okay, which it does. Let's just make this do the prepping. Good. Let's fry it and save it. Cool. Any questions? Otherwise, I'm going to probably rehost someone else who's solving it. Make sure you don't spoil them, though. All right. Have a good night, folks.